here with this bitch again.
I live here.
Hello, everyone. Welcome back to this channel, this dying carcass husk of entertainment that I call YouTube. I'm here with Alan.
Hi.
And we're reacting to Taylor Swift's Red, Taylor's version. I brought out the Taylor Swift Red photo book from the original Red era. Let's just go to the All Too Well page, because that's what we're all here for. This picture, do you see that? Oh, it has the lyrics. We love it. But we're here to listen to Red, Taylor's version. We are not doing the complete album because the thought of me having to sift through 4 hours of footage makes me, I'm gonna have a mental breakdown if that were to happen, but still wanted to react to it. So we're gonna be doing the vault tracks, but we will not be doing Ronin because we don't need to start off on that foot because it is the saddest song she's ever written. So we're gonna be starting with Better Man. Do you know the story behind Better Man?
I don't know anything, but I am a willing participant.
Okay, so Better Man, she wrote during the Red era, but she gave it to Little Big Town. You know Little Big Town?
I've heard of them.
Okay, and they released it a couple years ago, like officially. Like she gave it to them to use, so they have a country, their version of it.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is her fully, just her, how she wanted to do it.
Mm.
So that's the first one. Sounds similar to, it's very country vibes for sure. Oh yeah, you're gonna love this song.
The bravest thing I ever did was run. The middle of the night I can feel.
Oh, I got chills. Yes, I love that little crescendo moment. Sorry, Little Big Town. It's a wrap. You're singing different. Come on. It's a bop, right?
It is. I like
it's
it.
Really good.
It's country, but not too country.
Yeah.
Sing it, bitch.
Chills again, and I've heard this song. The backing vocal. Do you hear that lower register in the back? So, most of Red is about Jake Gyllenhaal.
That's what I assume.
However, I personally think this song is about John Mayer. Just like I think I Need Your Troubles about John Mayer. Maybe that's a controversial opinion. I don't know. But personally, I think she's talking about John Mayer. Insert that Kourtney Kardashian meme.
John Mayer. John Mayer. Huh. This is a good one. Okay. I'm going to go with a direction that I don't normally go in. So John Mayer.
You know what I'm talking about? So what did you think? First time hearing it.
It was good. Like I said, it was country, mm-hmm. but not like too country. It's kind of the Taylor
country
that...
pop. Yeah.
Yeah, that is the type of Taylor that I grew up on, which I'm sure a lot of people will resonate with that.
Mm-hmm.
So it's nice to hear that type of sound from her again with her mature voice.
Right. I loved it. Should have been on the original version because holy shit.
Because these are bonus tracks?
This one, yeah, this is like from the vault. So this was supposed to be on the Red album, but it got cut.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
Should have stayed in her hands because holy shit.
Yeah.
What a way to start. Okay, so the next track is the first brand new song. It's the one with Phoebe Bridgers. It's called Nothing New. I have seen a little bit of lyrics from this, but only because they're in the lover journals. Not the vibe I was expecting.
The way since I lost my novelty. It's like I can feel time moving.
It's giving me hometown open mic night.
Very bad. I'm not sure I'm keen on the melody.
I think that's what's not selling me.
Yeah. That
I like the chorus more than the verses.
Yeah,
so
same.
I still want me.
Pretty. Not my favorite.
It seems like they're in high school and they wrote a song and they saw that their local bar had an open mic night and they dragged their friends out to support their career and asked that cute boy to come along to see if he would like the song that
is about
that,
him.
Right.
But it definitely is that vibe. It's very open mic night. It could potentially grow on me. But it sounds like a bonus track. More so than the actual bonus tracks when Red was first released. This one sounds like it could have maybe stayed in the vault. Watch. Everyone who's a Nothing New stan is going to be like, Justin's canceled. But the melody in the verses is very odd.
It gives me a mirror ball sort of sound.
I love mirror ball.
To me, that's what it sounds like. And I'm not the biggest fan of mirror ball.
Oh, I love mirror ball. So far, I definitely prefer Better Man. 100%. Yeah. The next one is Babe. Do you know the story behind this one? Because I've heard it.
I'm sure you've told me.
Babe was also written in the Red era, but was given to Sugarland a couple years ago. I did a reaction to it on my channel. Go check it out. She's in the video and she's got like red hair and she's the other woman. She plays the other woman. Mm. Like the secretary that the guy's fucking on the side. Ah. Yeah. And I think you're really going to enjoy it because even the Sugarland version is very pop-esque, very country pop. And I have a feeling that this is going to be more pop than that country line, that Better Man Toys. I feel like it's going to be more poppy. I just feel like it has pop sensibilities in it. Mm-hmm. So I feel like she's going to play on the pop. That's new. It already sounds poppy. Yes, bitch, go low. Sing. I love it. It's perfect. And I love that. Not the Keely.
I'm getting a little tired of your broken promises, promises.
That's the only thing I'm thinking of.
I heard that O in the back. Chill. Oh yeah, break it down, bitch.
Promises, promises.
Stop! I'm getting a little tired of your broken promises, promises.
Here's what I'll say. I loved it, but I kind of would like to hear her raw a cappella over the Sugarland version, like the instrumental, because it was that country pop line.
Yeah.
And it was amazing. So I would like to hear her vocal over that instrumental because it does seem like it gets a little lost.
Yeah.
In the pop elements.
Yeah.
Where it doesn't have to. I like the Promises edition. I think it's really cute. And I think it speaks well to the song. But I would like to hear less produced version of it. Does that make sense? Because I know that you haven't listened to the rest of the album as far as like the Taylor's version. But there's this issue that I've been seeing or hearing rather that some of it's overproduced where the original wasn't. Like for example, We're Never Ever Getting Back Together. Like you can hear both equally the music and the vocal. And with the new version of We Are Never Ever Getting Back Together, you know the part where she's like, "Wee!" She doesn't sing it. It's just backing. So it sort of detaches itself. And I'm like, "What? Who mixed this album?" Because it's not, and it's only in like the pop songs. Mm. I didn't notice it as much in I Know You Were Trouble. I will say that. But in Never Ever, it's really, really noticeable. And I feel like that's Babe kind of takes that downfall as well. Or they like synthesized the pop elements too much.
The only thing I was going to say about Babe was, yeah, that the production kind of muffled the vocals for me.
Mm-hmm.
And at some parts I was just thinking this would sound a little bit, or it would go better than on the Red album. It would be better with 1989.
To me it sounds quintessential Red.
Really?
Very much so. Not necessarily, well, the vocals do. The melody and the vocals is quintessential Red. That production is like, I definitely would say it leans more towards 1989. But I want to hear her vocals over the Sugarland country pop version, because I feel like it would be perfect. So maybe I'll do it myself. Producer, actor, writer, director,
executioner.
Okay, so the next one is Message in a Bottle. That was the last of the ones that I've heard, or the ones that were given to other artists.
Oh.
Everything that's left is brand new songs. Of course, not excluding the 10-minute version of All Too Well, which I'm so excited about. I've heard it's a massive pop banger. Taylor confirmed this herself on TikTok. So
not the TikToks.
Yeah, so it's about to be a pop banger. Very 1989. Love that. Yes. Wasn't quite what I expected in the chorus. Hold on, I gotta pause. You know what it reminds me of? Is Gold Rush.
Really?
I don't know why, but it reminds me a lot of Gold Rush, especially because I didn't like Gold Rush at first.
I still don't.
I didn't like it that much at first. It's grown on me, and I love me some Gold Rush. And I feel like it's going to be that same vein for me. I like it. Like, when I heard the verses, I was like, oh, it's going to be lit. But then when it went to the chorus, I was like, oh. It didn't quite push itself over the hill like I thought.
So far, I like it.
I enjoy it. I think it's going to be a grower.
Not a shower.
Why does the chorus remind me of Cheetah Girls? Like, One World, specifically. Ooh, back in. Oh, I love this bridge. Okay, I'm back on board. Ooh, I love that part. Add this to the wedding playlist.
Probably.
That was pretty damn good.
Yeah, I'm shocked.
I had to go on the journey with the song. You know, I had to let it sit. I had to go through the 5 stages of love.
That's what Taylor Swift taught me was there.
Oh my God, she did.
Aww. Ew.
But yeah, I'm glad I ended up liking it.
I like it more than Gold Rush and Babe.
I still prefer, so far, Better Man. It's still Better Man for me.
It depends on what mood I'm in, because that song, I'm like, I'm more of the dancer between us. So I'm like, ooh, I want to shake my little booty.
And see, I'm more of the sit in the corner and cry and listen to Taylor Swift version, so. But it was good. I'm glad that I liked it in the end, but I'm waiting.
I love the end.
Oh, the ending was great.
Yeah.
But I'm waiting for one of the new songs to, like, really get me.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, we've only heard Nothing New and then this one so far.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting for one of the new ones to, like, really, like, this is the one, bitch.
Transitioning into the final chorus, you got me. Yeah. I was just like, booty was well shaken.
So the next song is called I Bet You Think About Me. It's featuring Chris Stapleton, who apparently is a country artist. I don't know that much about him.
I was going to say, like, oh, the one with the beard. They all have beards.
I have no idea. So I'm expecting it to be very more the countryside, but let's find out.
3 a.m. and I'm still awake. I'll bet you're just very Betty. Fast asleep.
Yeah.
It's better than mine in the good
bed. This is Betty.
I'm harder to forget than I was to leave.
Yeah, come for his neck.
Rolled your eyes at my jokes.
Oh!
Mr. Superior, thinking to your shrink to know that you'll never be happy. And I bet you think about me.
Hold on. She said, I don't have to be your shrink to know that you'll never be happy? Bitch! No wonder he don't shower anymore. He cries every time he goes in the goddamn shower. I mean, my God.
This is going to be an anthem to all the heartbroken bitches out there.
You just know that she went to fucking Scott. What's his name? The one we hate? You know, Big Red Machine. Are you thinking Steve Buscemi? That's No, what's his fucking name? I only know him by like that.
Not Buscemi.
It's not Buscemi. That's an actor.
Oh.
Scott Borchetta. Anyway, you know that he heard the song. He's like, we can't put this on the album. And Taylor was like, fuck you. Like, this is some good shit. This is tea. And we're only halfway through the song. What else is she gonna say? When she started saying like Silver Spoon, I was like, oh no.
Beverly Hills.
If I was Jacob Michael Gyllenhaal, I would be very upset. I don't know what his real middle name is. Oh, he sure does now, bitch.
Scared to get old. Chasing me was for none of that shit now. Cause you were with me.
I can't. Think about me when you're out at your cool indie music concerts every week. In your house with your organic shoes and your $1 million couch.
I bet you think about me.
Bitch, what?
She castrated that poor man vocally.
Came for his muscular tissue, bitch. Oh my god.
She added that very end segment. Just, the knife was already in. She just wanted to wiggle it a little bit.
She didn't wiggle it. She was just like, slash and gash and put another hole in your ass. That's what she did. That's the one. That one's my favorite by far.
Well, of course.
Does he have any movies coming out? Because he's got to cancel them. He can't do no press. He can't go anywhere out in public. He can't go to the damn Whole Foods down the street. He's done. As if All Too Well wasn't enough reason to not go out in public. That was beautiful. I didn't even care that it was very country because it sounded so much like Betty.
It was. Well, that's why in the beginning I was just like, because it really did.
That's the track. That is the track, bitch. I can't wait to re-listen to that and scream every goddamn word in my car.
Your organic shoes.
I mean, holy shit.
Just the specificness of stuff. That's what makes it so good.
All right, the next one's called Forever Winter. I'm expecting ballad. Sounds ballady.
Why fall in love just so you can watch it go away? He spends, I call, just checking up on him.
He's a, I love the melody. I hear drums. You are breaking down. Yes. Sing, bitch. I love this. It's very my vibe.
I like this part.
Yeah, the verses. Ooh. This hook? It's so good. I love her breathy nose. Ooh, I love that backing.
I say, believe in one thing, I won't go away.
Ooh.
I got chills again, the way she ended it.
That was good, the ending.
That one's probably my second favorite after I Bet You Think About Me. Really? As far as the new ones. Really? If I was ranking all the ones we've heard so far, I Bet You Think About Me, number one, bitch. Then either Forever Winter or Better Man. Nothing New has been my least favorite so far.
I don't know yet. I think Forever Winter is a result song of I Bet You Think About Me.
Interesting.
Well, because it was just like...
That you'll never be happy.
That you'll never be happy. And the next song is like her cradling this man child because he's like so depressed or fucked up.
Okay, next we have Run, which is the other song that she did with Ed Sheeran. Let's see if it's better than Everything Has Changed.
One, two, three.
Always Ed starting this.
Give me a reason, don't say no.
Ooh. 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 I'm not vibing. I don't know why.
I think it's trying to be too cute. Get your cardio in.
Okay.
I just kind of noticed this. I guess the oohs that they were doing might have been the sirens in which they were saying running.
Oh, cute! I could see that. That one's probably a grower. That one is, it, It's like the same thing with Nothing New. I see what they're trying to do, but initial listen, not my favorite.
Yeah. I would not reach for this.
No. And when we heard, like, the verses and, like, that little hook that it had, I was like, oh, shit. And then it gets to the run part, and I'm like, oh.
Yeah. Don't put me down for cardio.
I see why they went with Everything Has Changed over this song, considering that those two songs were birthed from that first writing session that they had during the Red Era. I see why they went with Everything Has Changed. Maybe it'll grow on me. It's not an instant classic, that's for damn sure, but it's pretty. All right, this is The Very First Night. It's our second to last song.
And so it goes, every weekend the same party. I never go, but they all lead back to you.
Yeah.
They don't know about the night, the hotel, Polaroid picture. They don't know how much I miss you.
I love this. This is it.
Not 2010.
I know, right? This is great. I love the guitar too. Yes. Aww. Fuck you, Jake Gyllenhaal, for doing this to Miss Taylor Allison. Gave her so much high highs, but so many low lows. Oh, I love this.
Apache says you.
Yeah. It's a certified bomb. Now that was just goddamn cute.
That brought me back to the old Taylor.
Yeah, I loved that one. That was really cute. You know, I was a little worried that I wouldn't like it based on the title, The Very First Night.
Mm.
But you know what? She has a good way of like plopping these titles and you think you know what they're gonna be, and then they're the exact opposite. Like, I Bet You Think About Me. I thought that was going to be completely different from what it was. I didn't know that I was going to be a bitch track. No idea.
Zone.
Oh my god, love it. Well, you know what time it is? It's time for the 10-minute version of We'll Do Well. I'm so, okay. The reason that I'm so hyped for this is because this has been rumored for years. I've been waiting for this.
Okay, dear.
And I'm so excited. Oh god, I'm ready. It sounds different. I like that though. Similar, but different. Where's the lighter? Get the lighter! I like that like synth heartbeat in the back. You hear it?
A little bit.
Love how she holds that U. I kind of like the new vibe for All Too Well on this version. It's different. No new lyrics yet. Still no new lyrics. I'm scared. Still no, I'm scared. When's it gonna happen? Did she just say fuck the patriarchy in my Taylor Swift song?
Indeed she said it.
Go back. Bye, Taylor Swift? Ending men in 2021? Absolutely. I love this pacing. Oh my god, I got chills. I gotta go. I can't do it.
Where are you going?
I can't do it. What Lord. The fuck? First of all, she said, fuck the patriarchy. And then she was like, by patriarchy, I mean Jake Gyllenhaal. Again, the details. It's all in the details. Her being like, you hold my lifeless frame 3 months in the grave? Because they dated for 3 months.
Oh, okay. See, I don't know the
tea.
Well, right, the specifics, but yeah. I have listened to the song, not this version, but the original version.
Well.
Probably like once or twice because you showed it to me.
Yeah.
So, I don't know the lyrics verbatim, but from what she just said, like, it's still, like...
gut-wrenching.
Well, yeah, it punches, and I'm like, oh, shit.
I'm scared to hit play. There's still, what, 7 more minutes? Oh, no.
Do you want me to hit play? Okay.
Fuck!
Damn.
Why did that get me teary? I want to hear her scream from her fucking soul. Yes! It was so good! That's how I feel. Crumpled up piece of paper. Oh my God. That's the ending of the original song. But the punchline goes, I'll get older, but your lovers stay my age. When your bridges between us, did the love affair maim you too? Cause in this end, how it goes and as it fell. Yeah. I was there in the background. Say a prayer, I was there. All too well for my ex.
So, for someone who is not emotionally distraught as Justin, I think it was a good song. The additional lyrics, I think, blended in just fine. Since I wasn't a hardcore fan of the first song, I didn't really, it wasn't grilled into me. So I thought the pacing was fine. The tea of the song was there. That... you keep me like a secret, but I kept you like an oath or something like that. That, yeah. Ooh.
Oh,
gut-wrenching. Gut-wrenching. And just, I think it's so relatable to multiple people, too.
I'm not okay. I'm not fine at all. I don't even know what to fucking say. I didn't think that that song could get better. By the end of the fade-out, you feel like you are a husk of a human. So, I think that that's... probably intentional, because holy fuck. You know somewhere in New York City, Jake Gyllenhaal's PR, Sarah in PR is like, what track is it? I bet you think about me in All Too Well 10-minute version. Let me listen. And she listened to it and she was like, Jake, sweetheart, you need to relocate. You need to go somewhere else. And possibly change your name. Because holy fuck. Between those two songs?
Yeah.
So you know that meme where it's like, I'm gonna be about this how people were about the Joker? Yeah. Yes. Yes. That's how I'm going to be about this 10-minute version of All Too Well. But so much worse. Oh my God. I'm just gonna do that ghostly vocal throughout the house.
Opposed to what? It's not anything new.
Would you say it's nothing new?
I know it all too well.
I love it. Okay, so let's talk about the best three, in my opinion, are... Hmm. I Bet You Think About Me, Savage. Absolutely savage. Knife to the throat, bitch. The Very First Night. Amazing, cutest little bop I ever did here. And then number one, surprising no one, 10-minute version All Too Well. What do you think?
Let's see. I would say, can I just say like a top three, but not like ranking them?
They don't have to be in order.
Not in order. Because again, I like Taylor Swift, but I'm not
a fanatic
Swiftie like Justin. So.
You don't subscribe to the Church of Swift. Right.
But I wouldn't mind, I guess, being married there, but I don't want
to
be
You have to be, because when we get married, we're going to be in the name of the Taylor, the Allison, and the Holy Swift. That's how it goes. Mm-hmm.
So my top three, Better Man.
Better Man's really great. Considering you've never really heard it, I understand that.
And I think that's why. It's because it brought me back to the whole Taylor.
It's an amazing, amazing song.
It brought me back to the old Taylor that I really like. And I guess I would say Message in a Bottle and All Too Well.
Really? Message in a Bottle over I Bet You Think About Me?
I mean...
It's not as ear-friendly, I guess.
Well, and that's the thing. I love the songs for, like, if you play them, I'm not gonna be like, bleh, or, like, anything like that. Mm-hmm. But for me, personally, like, I would not reach for that song. It's just more of a gotcha song than, like...
Oh, see, I'm here for everything else about.
And which is fine. Some people it's like
valid.
That.
It's not your thing. Yeah, that's fine.
Some people like that. It's just for me, I wouldn't want that.
Yeah.
It's either, like, kind of what you said of, like, I'm more the dancer, but you like the more, like, in the corner whatever songs.
I feel like you're very much, you listen to music to listen to the production, whereas I listen to music to listen to the lyrics. I'm more lyric heavy in my listening. If a song is sonically not good, let's say from an objective point of view, if it has really good lyrics, that will make me like the song, where I feel like you wouldn't necessarily feel that way. If it sounds bad, you would just think it's bad. On a more blanket statement.
I'll loosely agree with you, because I'm like, no, I'm not like that, but I can...
You didn't say The Very First Night.
Oh.
What about The Very First Night? You loved that one. Let's talk least favorites. Run, nothing new.
Run, Forever Winter.
Not Forever Winter. I like that one.
It's okay. I don't know.
It's not your vibe, and that you don't have to apologize for that. That's the vault tracks that... I'm literally going to never stop listening to All Too Well 10-minute version until I know every goddamn word of that novel. Every goddamn word. Thank you guys for watching this. I know that I haven't been doing reaction videos a lot. It's because I've got a lot of other things going on. If you want to keep up to date, listen to Bitches Brew, the podcast. Listen to Sailor Manga, the podcast. Alan's on Bitches Brew, so you get to hear Alan's opinions.
Pick 'em, leave 'em, shove 'em, whatever you want.
Of course, Marcella's on both of them with us on Bitches Brew. And it's just a great time. If you want to know up to date what music we're listening to, especially, we talk about it in our brief aperitif segment, which is usually something that's a little thing that's happening in our lives that's not necessarily on topic. And it's a fun time.
Yep. So you should definitely check us out.
You should, because we need people to rate and review it on iTunes so that you can get up in that algorithm, girl. But I think that's it. Thank you guys for watching. Stay unbothered. And until next time, bye!